I'm a surgeon and an internist, and I'm the CEO of a company called Anywhere. Anywhere is developing portable sterilization for surgical instruments and medical devices and equipment without electricity, without heat, in a very affordable, portable manner, which is quite amazing considering that bacteria and its role in surgical infections was discovered 150 years ago. And to this day, nobody has figured out how to sterilize instruments without electricity and heat. Whenever you make an investment, there are a number of risks that you run. The first one is technology risk. Okay, does it work? Has it been invented? Do you have to prove the drug works, or do you have to prove the sterilizer works? We have basically zero technology risk. That's a very strong thing. Second thing is, do you have a market? Our market is 2 billion people around the world who do not have access to adequate surgery. That is a very big market. And the people who are responsible for that, know that. And they're really interested in solving the problem. And the third very strong thing about us is we're the only show in town. We're the only product that can do sterilization of surgical instruments without electricity. There's nothing else. And the fourth thing is we have a great group of people. Impact investors need to understand that with a small amount of money, they can have a very big impact if they're careful with where they put their money and they look for the big ones. Big corporations do not invest in innovation. And there's no reason why philanthropy has to invest in innovation. It should be the impact investor who invests in the little guy who's the canary at the end of the stick who shows that it's safe to do something innovative. I'm an entrepreneur, and years ago I worked for Jonas Salk. Jonas Salk said to me one day, Jim, you don't meet very many people in this world who've ever done anything big. And by big, he meant something which impacted lots of people. And of course, he was referring to himself, Jonas Salk, who cured polio. But I was quite a young fellow at the time, and I decided I would take my abundant energy and intelligence and apply it to doing big things, which is I've done all my life. This one is big enough because it's 2 billion people in the world today with no electricity, who when they go to the hospital have to be operated on or have their laceration sewed up or their appendix taken out or their baby delivered with unsterile instruments. How would you feel if that was you?